Welcome back, everyone. Dustin here again, Average Guy Hi-Fi, with another subwoofer review for you guys. This is one that I've been waiting on, and I think many of you have been waiting on as well, because the comments, this has been the most requested piece of equipment. I've been trying to get my hands on this one for a few months now, but anytime it pops up, I have a day job, and I'm pretty busy during the day, so I'm not running around buying speakers during that time. I'm usually doing this kind of in the evening. So a lot of times people won't hold it, even when I throw out the offer, hey, I'll PayPal you $100, hold it for me, and then I'll come bring the rest of the cash. But they just want it gone. I understand, because there's a lot of kind of weirdos when you're selling stuff on there, which has made me realize it's finding a good buyer is important too when it comes to selling some of this stuff. So I just missed out on it a few times, which was kind of heartbreaking, because I know that people wanted me to grab this thing a long time ago. But finally, I got my hands on it. And what I'm sitting next to here is a BIC Formula F-12 subwoofer. The reason people wanted me to grab this thing was because I actually, there's the grill, so you can kind of see it. It's got a nice quality grill on it. The pegs, good quality, nice firm backing on the back of it. But the reason people wanted me to grab this one was because I've also reviewed the Klipsch R12SW subwoofer and the Polk PSW505. And if you're a member of the forums, or if you're on any of the audio social media groups, if you like come out with the question, say, hey, I'm looking for a subwoofer that's going to be under the $400, $300 range, this is one that very rarely, regularly comes up, along with the Klipsch R12SW and the Polk PSW505. And depending on what time of the year you're buying it, what the sales are, all three of them are going to be pretty comparable, I would say. But after my seat time with this one, I would say out of the three, this one has the edge when it comes to the bass performance. The other ones have like their own benefits and things like that, and they're all actually pretty close. If you're hearing this from me and you just bought a Klipsch R12SW from Costco for $149, keep it. It's not like you're going to be a huge increase going to this subwoofer from that subwoofer. Both of them are in the same ballpark of what they're intended to do. They're intended to give home theater performance, good quality, deep bass, but also be at an affordable price range. So all three of those are going to perform pretty similarly, like they did in my room, probably in your room. But it is like, if you're going to be making a decision and all of them are the same price, this is the subwoofer that I would go with, if that makes sense. This one does seem to have a little bit deeper bass, seems a little bit more maybe detailed than a couple of the other subwoofers. So, and that's why people wanted me to grab this one. I finally got my hands on it. So here we are. I'm just going to go over the specs with you. This subwoofer is about 17 inches tall. All three of those subwoofers are going to be pretty close when it comes to dimensions as well, too. It's about 16 inches wide. And with the knobs and stuff on the back, it's about 17 and a half inches deep. So it does have also like those other two subwoofers, it has a 12-inch front-firing subwoofer. And both those other subwoofers also had a rear port. The Polk had the slot port. This one has a rear port, very similar to that Klipsch subwoofer as well. Onto the amplifier, this has 150-watt RMS, 475-watt peak amplifier. Kind of has all your normal hookups. It's got the power on, off, and auto. I keep my subwoofers in auto. I hear a lot of people out there saying that they have issues with them turning on sometimes, but I've always left my dual subwoofers on auto. You know, I use those Martin Logans, and they kick on every time, so I usually just leave it on auto. But you have the auto off and on, then you have your phase switch. It goes 0 to 180. It has nice volume dials on here, and then it also has your crossover frequency. So just as a quick kind of besides this subwoofer, but always set this. If you're using receivers out there that have the room correction, always set your crossover on the subwoofer to the highest, so you're not missing out on any of the frequencies. Let the receiver figure out the crossover for the subwoofer. So I like the subwoofer too, because it comes with a detachable power cord. That's always something I like too. I'm always carrying speakers around, and it's more convenient just to pull the plug off. I'm getting old, so I don't want to trip on the cord and fall down carrying subwoofers. It'd probably hurt. These are just kind of some of the highlights. But another thing that I usually don't show you guys, but the subwoofer, I felt it was worth it. It really came with some high quality rubber feet on the bottom. And I thought, you know, they're not going to be as good as like, or as soft as say the SBS isolation pads that they have. But I was super impressed. I think more subwoofers should use this foot on there, especially if you have it on the hardwoods or a hard surface. This will do a good job keeping some of the vibrations down and isolate the subwoofer a little bit better. It's got a nice soft feel to it. And that's really, I mean, it should do a good job. There's better, but this is about as good as I've seen. any of the feet from subwoofer brands. So good job, Bic. You kind of, you put the money in some kind of good spots where really it would pay off from a performance standpoint. The frequency response, they claim, goes down to 25 hertz after listening to it for a while. I definitely think that that's achievable. But other than that, you know, this subwoofer with that Polk and that Klipsch subwoofer, any, if you have those other subwoofers out there, they're, you're set up, you're going to be very close. You're going to be within striking distance of this. I could probably A-B test all three of them and people wouldn't be able to tell the difference which one's which. So if you're looking for upgrades, then I think from these, because of how good all three of these are from a price standpoint, you're really going to have to jump up to something like SHU or SVS or Rhythmic or PSA or JTR. You know, the list goes on and on. It's a little bit tiring when I read the forums or the social media, especially. Somebody will be like, hey, I have a $400 budget. What subwoofer should I get? And then somebody will be like, oh, you should get the SHU subwoofer. Well, that wasn't $400. That's more like $600 landed. Or then somebody will be like, you need to get two PB16 Ultras. You know, now we're dealing with $4,000 plus, $4,500 in subwoofers. So from a expectation standpoint and a budget standpoint, this will be about as good as you can get under that $300, $400 range buying new. So that's why the subwoofer is requested. That's why I wanted to get my hands on one so bad so I could review it and see how it stacks up, in my opinion, based off of my five categories for the average guy hi-fi score, and then give you guys the impressions. So let's go over there. Let's check out a movie, show you this thing in action, and then we'll come back over here and I'll give you guys the average guy hi-fi score for the subwoofer. And then we're on to the next. I got some pretty awesome gear coming up for you guys. I bought some office equipment that I'm going to be using at my office that I'll show off here. And then I've also got some really cool speakers and subwoofers to review for you guys. So, but first, let's go over there. Let's get through this review. And then I'll show you the movie. And then we'll come over here and I'll give you guys the average guy hi-fi score. I hope you guys enjoyed that Tron demo. I mean, I hope you're not getting tired of it. It's just, that's one of those movies that I'm just waiting for it to come out in 4K. I know they're probably delaying the 4K release. Disney's probably delaying the 4K release until the new Tron comes out, which I'm super excited about. But I wish they had that one, and I wish I had Avatar in 4K. Those are the movies that I've really been waiting for. But anyway, Tron's a must own. The visual, the sound, the whole thing, it holds up. It's a little bit older of a movie now, but the bass is still some of the best I've ever heard. So if you guys are wanting to test out systems in there, definitely pick that one up. It's worth owning. So now we're on to the average guy hi-fi scoring section of the video. This is my favorite part. This is where I give you guys, there's five categories. Each category is worth up to 10 points, 10 being the best. We average those out and I give you guys the average guy hi-fi score. So the five categories are quality. We go off of the bass response. We go off of the MSRP. We go off the aesthetics. And then we also go off my price paid, average out the scores, and then I give you guys the average guy hi-fi score. So from a quality standpoint, I gave it an 8 out of 10. It's for its price point, it is very high quality feeling subwoofer. You know, the cabinet's not all that heavy, you know, so the, you know, more expensive subwoofers generally weigh a bit more because the amplifiers are bigger. The boxes are a little bit thicker, but for this price point, especially if you get this thing on sale, 8 out of 10 is a very good score. It's $475 MSRP pricing, but they really did a good job with the high quality woofer. The amplifier, even though it was only rated at 150 watts RMS, it still had plenty of power. It didn't feel like it was really waiting for anything. It didn't feel like it was struggling too much in my room. So overall, very high quality. I like the little baffle that they put around the edge, the speaker ring. And then again, the grill itself was a nice high quality grill. So 8 out of 10 when it comes to quality. When it comes to the bass response, which most people think is the most important when it comes to subwoofers, I'm not one to disagree with you. It's kind of a package deal for me, but bass response, you got an 8.5 out of 10. This subwoofer was going nice and deep. It felt detailed. It did feel like it was had more bass, you know, I'm going to be totally honest with you guys, than the Klipsch R12SW and the Polk PSW505. You know, and the frequency response getting down to 25 hertz, that's pretty impressive for something in this budget. Unfortunately, though, for movies, a lot of content, and it seems every year it gets more and more, they're getting down to like that 20 hertz, even some 15. It goes below that, but trying to keep up with, you know, hitting all the frequency responses of these new modern movies is going to make you go broke. But 25 hertz, nice and respectable, has nice, clean, tight, punchy bass. I didn't get a lot of boominess. I had to position a little bit differently than normal because of my Christmas tree. But I just really felt it was great in my room. It just did a good job pressurizing it, energizing it. The bass felt nice and deep. I've owned a lot of subwoofers, as you guys know, so I'm just giving my honest opinions on this thing. I think for its price point, definitely lives up to the online reputation that it has. MSRP, I gave it a 7.5. $475 is starting to get up there. It's starting to get up there to the shoe territory, which is, I hate gushing about that company, but I honestly believe that Shoe is making the best performing subwoofers within a budget. Spending $500, $600 on a Shoe subwoofer is going to get you something that's going to perform very, very well. Probably, you know, better than two of these things, I would say, in most rooms. So that's something that needs to be factored in. 7.5 out of 10 when it comes to the MSRP pricing. But the good news is this subwoofer can be had on sale, and that's really where it shines. As I'm making this video, Amazon has a subwoofer for $209. You might be able to do better than that. You know, Costco had that deal in the Klipsch R12SW subwoofer for $149, which is about as good as deal you're ever going to get for a brand new subwoofer with warranty. But I've heard people getting pretty good deals on these too. And $209, that's still a no-brainer at that price point. It's really hard to kind of go, it's hard to maybe go duals. You know, maybe if you have a $400 budget, maybe grab two of these. But then again, you're starting to kind of get within the Shoe territory, but it never ends. Once you go Shoe, then somebody's going to be like, well, if you want more performance, then go with the big Rhythmics, or then go with the PSAs or the JTRs. You know, it just goes on and on. But most of us out there, if you have reasonable expectations, you know what you're spending, you know what you're most likely getting. If you've done the research, watch the videos, then you'll be impressed with subwoofers like this in your room. And most people don't need to hit the full range frequencies like some of the nut jobs out there, like, you know, like myself. I would love to as well, but subwoofers is usually where I'm lacking, just due to space requirements and money. You know, spending $6,000 on subwoofers is not really in my cards either, so I'm sure I'm not alone out there. 7.5 out of 10 is pretty respectable score when it comes to the MSRP, but it's just, once you get to that price point, you can almost jump up to the next level. That's the reason it didn't score a little bit higher there. The aesthetics, 8 out of 10. As you guys know, if you watch my videos, I like speakers that have kind of black and silver speakers. So I think this thing looks nice and sharp with its grill on. They did such a good job with the grill. That's why I keep talking about it. It really just kind of blends in from a distance. It looks nice and clean. So this subwoofer will just go in your room, kind of blend in with stuff. You can put it on the side of a couch, or if you put it up front with a TV, maybe have duals. It's just a nice kind of clean looking. Looks about the same as the Polk and the Klipsch, if I'm totally honest with you. They're all going to look very similar 3 feet away. 8 out of 10 when it comes to the aesthetics. My price paid, I gave it a 7 out of 10. Picking the subwoofer up for $160 is still a great deal, but as you guys know, and I've said this before, I've got some really killer deals. So I've missed out on this subwoofer being listed for $120 a couple times. I even saw one, somebody had it listed for $100. It might have had more cosmetic condition issues, things like that. This one's not perfect either. It had a couple little dings and stuff like that. But the next owner that buys this from me for $160 is going to be very happy with its performance and the looks of it and kind of the shape of it. There's nothing that sticks out that's even really worth mentioning when it comes to condition. But a 7 out of 10, it's not the greatest score, but it's still respectable. So what's that add up to? We got quality is an 8. We got the base responses at 8.5. We got the MSRP pricing at 7.5. We got the aesthetics at an 8, and we got the price paid at a 7. That averages out to 39 out of 50, which is a 78% average guy hi-fi score. This just edged out the Klipsch subwoofer and the Polk subwoofer. So it's really close. The Klipsch beat this one in some categories. The Polk beat them. And, you know, it's like a, I would just go for whichever one of these is going to be on sale. Like that Klipsch subwoofer for $149 is such a good deal that you can get two for $300 and be pretty happy for a long time until you want to take that next jump. But if you're looking at any of those three subwoofers, or if you own any of these three subwoofers, you got something that's better probably than 90% of the people out there, maybe 95% of the people out there. These are high quality. The bass gets nice and deep. It's detailed. It fills larger rooms just fine. But just know that in this category, this price range, that people will always tell you that you can get more. And the truth is, you can. You definitely can by jumping up to a $1,000 subwoofer or jumping up to a $2,000 subwoofer. But at what point does it really, never really ends? And most of us have out there, it's like they want to come home, watch a couple movies a week, and you don't need to have $6,000 with the subwoofers in your room. There'll be some out there that tell you that you do need it. But again, I'm not one of those people. You got a budget, stick to the budget, do your research. You'll be able to build a system that performs very well, no matter what people tell you on the internet. So just keep that in mind. And again, that's what this type of channel is for. Just letting people know that there's good deals to be had. You can build this over time. Youthman's another good YouTuber that I've gone back and forth with him for many years. We were on the Klipsch forums together, things like that. Very knowledgeable. He's very good at getting deals. That was part of my reason for starting this channel. It was just doing, you know, seeing the deals that he was getting at the same time the deals that I was getting. We were kind of comparing. He always seemed to, where he lives, he seems to get better deals than I do. But I'm also in a pretty rich environment, too, when it comes to used audio equipment. I think that has to do with people moving in and out of the Seattle area so frequently for work. So, rambling on now, but anyway, my name is Dustin. The name of the channel is Average Guy Hi-Fi. The growth has been outstanding. You guys are helping me spread the word. I'm seeing my name pop up on Facebook. Somebody has a question. It's all working. So I'm at 2,800 subscribers right now, a little over 2,800 subscribers right now, and I'm about 9 months into this thing. So it's working. I'm going to keep making the content. I got a lot more for you guys. So I hope you're all enjoying the holidays. This is obviously a very strange year with COVID, but I hope you guys are surrounded by love and friends during the holidays. And I'm around. If you guys have questions or if you have any comments, feel free to leave them below. Thank you very much.